Of searching for a missing toddler at a campground in Elk River ended in heartbreak.
So sad.
Yeah, yesterday, crews found the body of Daisy Jo Holland in the river, not very far from where she was last seen alive.
And now the community that was so involved in this search for her is doing what it can to show support and comfort to her family. 5 Eyewitness News reporter Kate Renner is joining us live in the newsroom this morning with the latest on this effort. Kate.
Well, volunteers want Daisy Jo Holland to have a party up in heaven today on what would have been her second birthday. So a balloon release is being organized for this afternoon at the Lake Orono volleyball courts in Elk River. All weekend long, hundreds of volunteers showed up to search the Wapiti campgrounds and the banks of the Elk River. For nearly 2 days, law enforcement searched by land, air, and water. But on Sunday, around 2 p.m., her body was pulled out of the river. Many of the kids staying at the campground were among the first to help look for her. And these girls say they were praying for her safe return, but now they are praying for her peace and for her family.
I said, I hope that she has fun where she is, and it was a really bad way to die that she did.
It was all worth it, because if it was celebrating a weekend or finding a life, I'd rather find a life.
Photographer will be at the event, and there will be a guest book as well at the balloon release this afternoon that will be able to document the community support that comes out today and will be given to the Holland family. Now, anyone who is planning to attend the event is asked to bring their own balloons or to bring flowers if you want to drop those in the water. Again, that memorial is at the Lake Orono volleyball courts at 4 o'clock this afternoon. Reporting live in the newsroom, Kate Renner, 5 Eyewitness News.
Kate, thank you.